Girls were actually getting raped. People were actually getting killed.
This was the end of Pruitt-Igoe housing projects that started as a complex of 33 high-rise buildings that opened in 1955 with 2,800 families, costing taxpayers about $57 million. But the hopes of many for a better life ultimately came crashing down. I too remember a lot about Pruitt-Igoe. I grew up in this now falling down house on Gamble. It's a house right across the street from what we simply called the projects. The Pruitt-Igoe has long since been torn down. As you can see behind me, it's just vacant tree-covered land now. Now, after I made my post on Facebook with me as a child in front of Pruitt-Igoe, a lot of people reached out with their stories of life in the projects.
What was it like when you first moved in Pruitt-Igoe?
Oh, it was great. You know, we were poor, you know, coming up. There was 10 children in my family, and we were glad to move in there. I mean, the apartments were really nice.
Today, Julia Gillespie is a retired factory supervisor living in a middle-class neighborhood of St. Louis County. But she vividly remembers life as a child in the projects with a family of 10 brothers and sisters. She talks about the changes just 10 years after Pruitt-Igoe opened.
How violent did it get?
It got bad. I mean, there was murder, there was robberies. When you heard guns out, you went in the house, you locked the doors, and you sat on the floor and watched television until it stopped because you didn't know what was going to happen.
Imogene Menzies is a retired healthcare worker. When I went to her apartment, she had a picture of her on the table showing a group of people, including me, at a Pruitt-Igoe reunion. She has vivid memories of her at her family's apartment in Pruitt-Igoe after things turned bad. The lights were out in the stairwell. She had to climb to get to her apartment in the high-rise building.
It was so dark, that you couldn't see your hand in front of your face. And that's when someone grabbed me between those two floors and put a knife to my throat and told me to be quiet. I was 12. He was attempting to rape me.
She escaped, but she said she had to run this gauntlet every day.
The second time I was crossing the fourth floor hallway, there was a utility room at the end. Someone came out of it, grabbed me by my neck, and dragged me with the hair over my mouth back into the utility room.
Once again, she escaped.
No, he had a twin.
Mary Jane Williams is a retired teacher who grew up in Pruitt-Igoe. Pictures of her from her days as a child bring back memories of the good and later the bad. I talked to her and her friend Joyce Miller, who also grew up in the projects, about a horrible memory they both witnessed in 1964 when they were both 13 years old.
I heard shots and I saw this man just laying on the building. It was a policeman.
They say that policeman who was killed turned out to be St. Louis Police Officer Paul McCullough, the father of St. Louis County prosecuting attorney Bob McCullough.
When you see a life leave a body more or less, it does have an effect on you.
By the late 60s, just 600 families remained of the thousands that once lived here. Everyone I talked to said the demolitions that started in 1972 were long overdue to put a final end to the disaster that started as a dream.
I wanted something better out of life than what, you know, I saw down there.
And I just wanted to be a product that came from Pruitt-Igoe that people wouldn't, you know, couldn't look at and say, nothing good come out of Pruitt-Igoe.
So right now, the old Pruitt-Igoe site is just a huge 57-acre overgrown tract of land. The Slay administration says it's looking at plans by some people who want to develop at least a part of it. I'll let you know if those plans get off the ground. After all, you paid for it.